Well, they did announce, this is one thing I do know about next year. One piece of information that I do have that I can potentially confirm as not being a rumor is the fact that we've always done our crossovers with Arrow and Flash, and then we had our this one with Legends. Now, this year, we're going to do a crossover of Arrow, Flash, Legends, and Supergirl. How? I don't know, but it is apparently set to happen. So, yeah, we're all very excited to be hopping into each other's realms, and all I gotta say is I want to be in Earth 2, so as long as that happens, I'm happy.
Me too.
Earth 2 seems so much better than regular Earth.
As an actor, how do you feel about crossovers?
They are interesting in the sense that, like, we all love each other because, I mean, Flash shoots literally next door to us, so I can walk over and steal from their catering if their lunch is before mine. It's great. So I take advantage of that all the time, and Grant and Danielle and all of them are great close friends. And Legends, even though it shoots in LA, I mean Vancouver as well, their stages are a little bit off from ours, but we all still get to, like, you know, run into each other and hang out in the cities. So we're already kind of like a knit close family on our own rights away from the show. So it's always really fun coming to each other's and getting to play with each other on set. But the actual building of the crossovers and shoving it into our seasons, when we have 23 episodes and 8 days to do each of those episodes, it's a very difficult thing because we're all of a sudden not making 1 hour of television in that 8 days. We're somehow supposed to accomplish double the amount with twice the amount of people.
But whenever I walk on set after they've done a crossover, everyone is so shattered.
Yeah.
Just completely shattered, but the response that you get from every single one of them is, we love doing the crossovers because the fans appreciate it so much.
Exactly.
And that is
so worth it.
The honest to goodness response from everybody, from Steven down to the crew, that they love doing them even though they are just knackered by the end of it.
Yeah,
so
it's when we start going over our legal hours of work and pretending like we're not. And we all end up living on set and we lose our Saturdays and sometimes our Sundays, and it becomes a bit of a jumble, but it's all in the end tiringly worth it. And the jokes and the vibes on set are always just as positive as they are normally.
Play your character on a different show.
I mean, it's we're playing the same character throughout it, so it's not like there's much of a difference. If, you know, I got to go to Earth 2 or got to do something like Katie is just becoming a whole different superhero, it would be awesome to be able to actually really play around with, like, a totally different version.
If you could invent your own Earth 2 character, what would you have them do?
Well, I keep on saying that Speedy or Thea needs to be in Earth 2 as Artemis and or as Speedy with a yellow cape, because that's just something I need in my own personal life. If I am not the first person on the show with a cape, I might lose it. It's like my one requirement. It's the one thing I've asked for since day one. It's been 4 years, guys. Can we please start this whole fan tweeting thingy or whatever that says
hashtag
Thea,
get Thea.
Cape, Speedy cape, whatever. Just get it going. I need it. That'd be amazing with a cape. Just all that matters. Good or evil. Just amazing. Yeah.
Oh, my God. Yes.
What is this? Oh, my God. I'm actually in the Superman colors, too.
Thank you. I feel so
like,
I feel like
back.
Grant Gustin gets to heal every day.
Now, why?